Hello dear student, in this video we will start new chapter that is about the supporting input output devices. Now here we are going to learn what is a port, which are the different types of ports are available, what are the different connectors for keyboard, which are the different types of monitors and some video cards. So in this chapter we are going to focus on the input output devices and its connector types. So first today we will learn about the USB. Now ports means what? Ports, it is just a physical connector, physical docking point you can say. Docking point means connecting point. So it is a connecting to your computer. So here the context we are taking as in a computer, laptop or tablet. So these devices we want to connect, and for that we require some port. And with the help of this port, we can attach external devices. So these ports should be present on your machine, and then you can attach your pen drive, keyboard, mouse, even you can connect to printer, scanner. So these external devices we have to connect, and for that we require some port for that. So this is about the ports. Now which are the ports? You can see this diagram. Now here you can see these are the different ports are available on your computer. You have seen that on your laptop also you can connect to a modem. So according to its characteristics, its structure is a different one. So what kind of data it is accepting, according to that these ports are available. So the first port we are going to study, that is about the USB port, that you are very familiar with this USB port. What is a USB port? Here this diagram it is shown that is your pen drive and you are connecting to your laptop. Now here this is a USB port, this structure, and you can connect any kind of USB drive. So that can be external pen drive, that can be a external hard disk, you can connect your mobile also. So these are the different ways that you can connect to your computer, your desktop or your laptop. So what is USB? USB stands for universal serial bus, and it allows the communication between the computer and the peripheral devices. Now what kind of communication happens between external devices and this computer? Now this external devices, it is carrying the data. Why are you connecting pen drive? First of all, to store some information into your computer which is present in the pen drive, to transfer the information from one place to the another place, that is the use of this pen drive. So you can connect this and you can get that information. So to read that information, we have to connect it somewhere. So somewhere means that should be your laptop, or that can be your simple desktop machine. So for the communication, it is very important part which plays a role. Now here the communication that you can transfer the data to and from, that is you can transfer from this external device to your computer or from computer to this external device. So this communication requires that first of all, it will establish the power connection. Then this driver will be get installed. And once it is installed successfully, it's a driver, then you can transfer the data. So main basic purpose for any kind of port, the communication between these devices and that particular machine. Now these interfaces used where it can be used to connect printers, it can be used to connect scanners, keyboards, mouse, then game controllers, then even you can connect it to a digital camera. If you have DigiCam, just connect it with the help of the cable provided with this USB port. Then you can see that you can access these photos into your laptop and you can store it into your laptop. So how many of these peripherals can be connected? Up to 127 peripherals are connected. Maybe more than 127 peripherals are connected to any devices. For that, we require some USB hubs connection. Now, it provides one facility. That's why this USB is very popular one. It is providing the hot swapping and plug and play facility. Now, what is this hot swapping? I mean, suppose I have started my machine and now I want to connect to a pen drive. So this you can add this pen drive, you can attach this into your port, and once you attach this into the port, it will be directly detected by your computer with the help of the device drivers, and then you can read that data. So no need to reboot your machine. Suppose your keyboard or the mouse, it is using this USB drive, and your computer is in a working condition, and your mouse, you feel that your mouse is not working properly. So you remove this USB cable, USB port, USB cable through this USB port, and again you are reattaching that one, fixing again one. Then again this mouse will be get detectable. But suppose this mouse is using the old type of connectors, keyboard using old type of connector, just like a PS2. You might have seen that is a ring shape. So that type of connectors or the ports will not support once your computer started. You have to shut down your machine, then detach that particular mouse connector or keyboard connector, and again attach it, the 6-pin connector. And then this will be get detectable. But that is not the case with the USB. USB, you can remove at any time. You can, again, attach at any time. It just like a plug-in. So it's why that's called as a feature, as a plug-and-play. Just attach it and it will get start working. So no need to restart your computer every time when you want to connect some external devices. So that's why this USB is very popular one. Now let's go through some versions of this USB. In 1994, it is started, it is developed, USB 0.8. Then the first one, 1995, it is released with the version as a 0.9. Then 1996, USB 1.0 released, and it's a data transfer rate of 12 Mbps. 12 Mbps means 12 megabits can be transferred at the 1 second. Then 1998 USB 1.1, 2000 USB 2.0 started the list, and its transfer rate is up to 480 megabit per second. Then 2008 USB 3.0 introduced, which is having a speed of 5 Gbps. Means 5 GB of data can be transferred at 1 second. And especially 2019 USB 4 version released, and its speed is about the 40 gigabit per second. So if you see the next version, so latest version is the USB 4 version, it is the latest one. And if you go to the next newer versions, you can see its speed has been increased. So you can transfer data of maximum amount with a minimum time. So you can see USB 4, it's having a speed of 40 gigabits per second. In 2008, that is this 3.0 USB, its speed is about the 5 Gbps. And if you go above with the one version, then you can see 1.0, which is having a speed of only 12 megabit per second. Now this USB having a type of connectors, A type connector and B type connector. A type connector, it is used to transmit power as well as data. And B type connector, it is used as only for the power connection. Now this, you can take power and data transmission where it is required. It is required for keyboard, mouse, even for your pen drive. So where, first of all, we have to connect, and as well as we have to transmit the data. So these devices are connected with type as an A. Type B, which is only connected, required a power connection. So for example, we can take as a printer. So that's of the type B. Now, why exactly this USB has been developed? Now, which are the major companies are working on that? You can see NEC, Corporation, Nortel, Intel, Compaq, and so on. So these are the major companies started to develop USB in 1994. Because in old days, if you see that ports, these ports are very different for every devices. And to develop the programs for every devices, to store it into your computer, to store it into a that particular device. It's very consuming one, time consuming, and better than that, there should be a one device, same port that should work for the every devices. So it will minimize the work for interfacing between external device and your computer. That's why this USB has been developed. Now, one feature just I told you about the hot swapping, that is the best feature of the USB. So that just you no need to reboot it, just plug that device and you can use that device. Now, which are the USB devices that you can connect with the help of USB ports? Keyboard, phone, your Android phone, or your smartphones, not only Android, your any kind of phones you can connect. Then tablet, web cameras, keypad, microphones, mouse, joystick, scanner, printer, external device, iPod, MP3 players, and digital camera. So these are some few examples, popular examples, that are using USB ports for connecting. Now, where are the USB ports locations on your laptop, desktop computer, tablet, and the smartphone? Now, you might have seen some pen drives, which right now you can connect to your laptop as well as you can connect to your smartphones also. So these smartphones where you are doing the charging, that port you can use to connect to for transferring your data to a latest pen drives also. So these USB connector types, you can see some few types. Mini USB, this one mini size is showing it's a minimum size. Somewhat bigger, that is a micro USB, and USB type C. This C type you can use from any side. So from both the side it works at the same way. So these are the some features has been given for the mini USB and micro USB and C type. The transfer rate just we have seen, which one is it is having a latest maximum transfer speed? It is of USB 4, USB 4 and USB 3 after before that USB 3. So according to this compatibility of the version, USB version, suppose you are using USB 3 or USB 4, and whether it is work for USB 3 or not, yes, it will work for the USB 3 technology. But what will happen that even though it is having a capacity of transferring data at a high speed, so it has to accommodate with the low speed. So for the USB, if suppose USB 3.1, device is connected to USB 2.0 port, then what will happen? It's a maximum transfer rate. It is limited to 2.0. Are you getting this point? Now see, USB 3, it is having a speed of up to suppose 5 GB per second. And USB 2, just we have seen it's about 480 megabit per second. Then it is supporting the maximum transfer rate of this minimum version. Now, which one is the minimal version? 2.0, back version. So back version, it is having a 480. Then up to that speed, it can transfer the data, even though your device, it is the latest one. So that is only one drawback, but it is supporting. So it doesn't matter that which type of version of device you are using, still you can transfer the data with a low rate provided by that port speed. So that is about the version compatibility. So in this video, we have learned what is an USB, that is a universal serial bus, and where it is used. It is used to connect these external devices. Then we have seen some history part. Latest version is USB 4, and it is released in 2019. Its speed is up to 40 gigabit per second. Then we have seen its plug and play feature, hot swapping feature. Then some list of devices and where it can be used. These are the connector types and compatibility, transfer speed, and the compatibility. So in next video, we will cover the next type of port. Now we will stop here and thank you.